born in the car, not in the palace. Because, you know, in India, that time there's a custom for women. When she's ready to give birth, she gives birth to her family size, her parents' size. So when the queen was ready to give birth, she asked permission from her husband, the king, to go to her family side, to her, you know, father, kingdom. It during that trip that, you know, she saw that tree full of flowers. She wanted to get closer to that tree. Mm-hmm. And holding one branch, she gave birth. And she was standing.
Yeah, I see that.
And you see all these, the picture of the, you know that one guy, four faces?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This one. That Lord Brahma, you know Brahma?
Mm-hmm. Brahma.
Yeah. Four faces that represent the four qualities of Lord Brahma. Mm-hmm. That be love, compassion, mm-hmm. some positive joy, and equanimity. And there are some people use those four qualities to make meditation.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, when you make meditation on love, for example, you take a picture of one person that you know, and you see that I know that person better. And then say, you bring a picture of a stranger, you have the same love for that.
Oh, okay.
And then you bring a picture of the enemy that you hate. If you have the same love. Until you have a law, you know what it won't be. I mean, make no difference between these people. I think you can say that. Mm. Some people will do meditation on that. Mm. Test. And then, well, the second picture, you see that they put that standing on the head of yeah. The well, when she was pregnant, she had, you know, one. The Buddha was in the book. She had a dream. And in that dream, she saw a white elephant placing a lovely flower in her book.
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't know what it meant exactly. So, you know, her husband, the king, asked all the well known Brahma to come and explain about that dream, the meaning of that dream. And so, two meanings in that dream. Either the boy will be a powerful one if he choose to rule, or he becomes a Buddha if he choose a religious life. But his father didn't. Second condition. So when the boy was growing up, his father made all the precautions not to allow that boy to see anything bad. So from childhood to adulthood, he was surrounded by luxury, you know, beauty, anything. And then when he was old enough, now you get to the picture of Shirley. That we call that the fourth sign. The first trip he made out of the palace, he saw an old person, something that he never seen before. Ugly.
Yeah. Okay. Suffering.
It would be. Yeah. And then he realized that he didn't become powerful enough. Second trip, he saw a sick person.
Oh.
And then, and the third one, he saw a dead body. And the fourth one, he saw the he was shocked. Okay. he was married. But he hardly knew that that infant that was born. Here, here I have is a newborn infant. Because he didn't stay in a palace. He had to fulfill his duty as a prince, be a father and be a husband. Mm-hmm. So there's no way for him to find, because he couldn't find the truth. Why we have to be born when we're all together? Mm-hmm. Is there any way of escape from the cycle of suffering? And then he decided to leave everything. And then he decided, you know, he got rid of all the jewelry and all this stuff. And he came and accepted the person. He went to a very far away from his kingdom because he didn't want anybody to know that he was a prince. And then, as an ascetic person, he had to pay for food. And then he went out for bread. And then people in that kingdom found out that this guy is so different. He's the way he walks, the way he talks, so different. And then he went all the way to the king in that kingdom. And the king found out that all of this guy is a prince from another kingdom. He came here and then he became an ascetic person in order to find the truth of the minister, you know, about the suffering. And he proposed him to build a road to heaven for him to stay. And then all of my desire to be here, not to be in a good place, but to find solutions to human suffering.